this video, you'll see how to install AContent and integrate it with the ATutor learning management system. To begin, download the latest version of AContent from the atutor.ca website. This will download from SourceForge. Once you've downloaded, you want to copy the bundle onto the server. So using your FTP client, in this case WinSCP, copy the bundle over to the server like that. Now you'll need to unpack that. In some FTP clients, there will be an option there to unpack the bundle, but in this case I need to use an SSH client to log in and unbundle the tarball on the server. So in this case I'm using PuTTY. I'm in the directory where the tarball is, right there. So to unzip it, I do tar xzvf acontent, like that. And it creates the installation directory. So now I go to my web browser to the directory where the content was uploaded and unpacked, reload, and there you go. So if I open up the AContent directory, it will bring up the installer. Click on continue onto installation. So in the first step, it checks to make sure all of the requirements to run AContent are in place. In this case, they all are. So you click on the install button, agree to the terms of the GNU General Public License, the GPL. Then set up the database by entering your database information. Next. It sets up all of the tables for AContent in the database. If there are any errors here, you'll need to correct the errors. Click Next. Now you need to set up some users for the system. An admin user. You'll need to set up a contact email. Can be the same email if you like. And you'll need to set up the first author user for the system. So I'll set this up quickly. All of this information is required so that whenever content is created, it can be properly attributed to the author. So once your users are set up, click Next. Now you need to set up the content directory. So to do that, you'll need to go back to your SSH client and go into the content directory. The AContent directory, and do an ls, and there are all of the files. So here you need to create a directory called AContent. It can be called anything, but for consistency with the documentation, etc., call it content. So mkdir, mkdir, content. And then you click Next, and it's going to complain that the permissions are not set. So you need to make the directory writable. So you can go chmod 2 to set the sticky bit for the group, and then 777 content to make the content directory writable and to make it owned by the group that the shell account is a member of. That will allow you to delete the content directory later if you need to move the AContent directory out of the way. So now I can go on to the next step. So now it's telling me that the configuration file needs to be writable as well. So we do chmod a plus read, write, and execute for the config file, which lives in the include directory. Click on try again. So now it saves everything. Go on to the next step. This collects some anonymous information about the server that AContent is running on to help with development. You can choose to not send the URL to the AContent installation by unchecking include this URL as well. And then click next to complete the installation. So have a look at your installation, make sure everything is running correctly. And once you've confirmed that, you can delete the install directory and reset the permissions on the config file to read-only. After clicking on Go to AContent, on the last screen of the AContent installer, you open up the homepage for AContent, which looks something like this, one default course with instructions on how to use AContent. Click on the login link. Enter the login information for the author user that you created during the installation. You now have the ability to create a lesson. Here you have two options. You can either create a new lesson from scratch, or you can import a content package or a common cartridge as the initial content for a lesson. So I have a common cartridge available right here. So we'll open that and press the import button. And this will take a few moments. And there you go. Contents all installed. Quiz is available. So now you want to get this content into ATutor. So to do that, you first of all need to integrate ATutor and AContent. So any AContent user can do this, but only the ATutor administrator can actually create the link. So click on your profile for your author user. Any author user will do. Under Web Service ID, copy the ID. Then go to your ATutor installation. Logged in as the administrator, click on AContent Setup under System Preferences and enter the Web Service ID into the Web Service ID field. Paste that in and then set the seconds down at the bottom to control the amount of time that ATutor will stay connected to AContent before a person has to re-log in. In this case, it's set to 26 hours. So we'll save that. Now we will go into one of the courses on this server. So we have a copy of a course that's currently empty. And we'll log into that course. Now you can see that it's just the welcome message is listed in the content navigation, so we're going to import some content. To do that, you click on Manage. In the Content section, click on AContent. Now you can search the AContent repository remotely, so we will look for the word accessibility. Search for that, comes back with one result. So this is the cartridge that we just imported into AContent. You can click on this link to open a window and view the content. So that's the content we just imported. Close that, but what we want to do is import it. So we click on the import icon. You can also download it as a content package. So we click on import. Asks you where you want to import it to. So in this case, we're going to import it as a top level page. Click on import. And there you go. All of your content has now been imported from a content. Content page. Oops. Content page. And your quiz. Of course, tests and surveys, you need to set the date on the quiz before it becomes available. So now that you have your content in ATutor, you can export it out to AContent. So to do that, go to Content, Import Export. Choose the content you want to export. In this case, we'll choose Principle 1 Perceivable. Select Common Cartridge as the export format and click Export Content to AContent Repository. And click on the Export button. Sends the content off to AContent, which takes a few moments, and comes back with the link to the content in AContent, which you can click to open AContent and review the content that you've exported over. So that's it. That's how you install AContent and integrate it with the ATutor Learning Management System.